Dear friends, this is Prithivi Raj from Bangalore connecting with you once again through this short message on righteousness of God. Isaiah 45:21 says that our God is righteous. Righteousness of God would refer to the absolute moral perfection and absence of all sin. Richard L. Strauss in his book, The Joy of Knowing God, says, God's righteousness is the natural expression of His holiness. If He is infinitely pure, then He must be opposed to all sin, and that opposition to sin must be demonstrated in His treatment of His creatures. Because God is righteous and just, He has established moral government in the world, laid down principles which are holy and good, then added consequences which are just and fair for violating those principles. Daniel 9:14 says, The Lord did not hesitate to bring the disaster on us, for the Lord our God is righteous in everything He does, yet we have not obeyed Him. The Lord demands obedience from all men without partiality. Ecclesiastes 12:13 says, Fear God and keep His commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. God in His righteousness condemns sin and punishes the wicked. Due to their fallen nature, mankind is unable to live up to the expectations of God. Righteousness cannot be obtained by works or efforts. Strict legalism will not make us righteous before God. We are all infected and impure with sin. We are told in Romans 6:21 to 24 that God has shown us a way to be made right with Him without keeping the requirements of the law. We are made right with God by placing our faith in Jesus Christ. And this is true for everyone who believes, no matter who we are. For everyone has sinned, we all fall short of God's glorious standard. Yet God in His grace freely makes us right in His sight. He did this through Jesus Christ when He freed us from the penalty for our sins. Therefore, we understand that we are accepted as righteous by God on account of what Jesus has done. He was made sin, and we are made righteous before God. And also, the righteousness of God is an effective defensive weapon in our spiritual warfare. Being made righteous with God is not the end of our spiritual life. We are expected to seek His righteousness and live a righteous life. Matthew 5:6 says, Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. In Matthew 5:20, Jesus said, Unless your righteousness exceeds the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees, you will no way enter the kingdom of heaven. In Romans 6:13, we are advised to yield our body as instruments of righteousness. In Ephesians 5:8-12, we are told to walk as children of light in all righteousness. In 1 Timothy 6:10, we are asked to pursue righteousness. Friends, righteousness ought to be the character of every follower of Christ. 1 Timothy 3:16 suggests that studying God's word helps us to grow in righteousness. Let us spend more time studying and obeying the Word of God and thereby reflecting the righteousness of God in our life. Thank you for listening. God bless you.